Hallelujah. We're on the sixth watch and we glorify the name of the Lord. At this time, we honor him as we come into another time of what Paul said about prayer. We are grateful to the Lord for giving us capacity and the way for us to be able to call on his name at this time in the name of Jesus. Oh, Father, we pray for your mercies upon us in the name of Jesus. Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine, full test of glory divine, with his son washed in his blood. Hallelujah. Now of his spirit washed in his blood. This is my story. This is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long.
Perfect, listen.
Hallelujah, perfect delight. Visions of rapture now burst in my hallelujah. Angels descending, bring from above, echoes of mercy, whispers of love. Say, this is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long.
Perfect submission.
Hiya! All is at rest, I in my Savior, I'm happy and blessed.
Hallelujah. Perfect submission, all is at rest. What a joy that this scripture, blessed assurance, this wonderful hymn, blessed assurance, perfect submission, all is at rest. I in my Savior am happy and blessed. That is my status right now. Perfect submission to the will of the Lord. Beloved, we continue to talk about this wonderful discussion as the Lord helps us in this time as we get to these truths and also get to learn to pray. Paul's instruction to obtain God's peace. As we are ending the other watch, we prayed and also mentioned about this in the book of Philippians. When Paul was giving this instruction to the Philippian church, he said that first be careful for nothing. That's the first thing. We don't talk that way in modern language, because the Amplified translation says it a little bit more clearly. It says, do not fret. That is the reason many Christians don't have the peace of God in their lives. They are always fretting. Do not fret. The word fret is something that you may not be able to think that you do very often, intercessor. But there's something called fret. And when you look at fretting, it is troubled. It is to be troubled, to be vexed, to worry, to be worn, to be eaten away, to become corroded. Do not fret or to move agitatedly. That is what fret is. Oh, I need to finish this work. I need to do this. I need to do this. That will being able to fret. It says, do not fret. In the book of Philippians chapter 4 verse 6, it tells us clearly, do not fret. Don't fret. It's the reason that many of us don't have the peace of God in our lives, because we are always fretting. It says, do not fret or have anxiety about anything. Fretting and anxiety seem to go hand in hand, don't they? Well, the first step to obtain God's peace is to refuse to fret, is to refuse to be anxious about anything. That is the number one reason why people don't have this peace, which passes all understanding. They are fretful and full of anxieties. The Bible says, do not fret or have any anxiety about anything, according to the Amplified. Beloved, these scriptures, sometimes when we read them out and people look, the people have looked at me in astonishment. And I'm not talking about people who don't know the word. I'm talking about born again, spirit-filled people who should have known and practiced the word better than they did. They would look at me and their eyes would get big and they would say, well, if I'm not supposed to fret, what am I going to do then? And others can't worry about, if some people can't worry about a situation or circumstance, they don't know what else to do about it. That leaves them almost frantic, you know. It's very sad when you know what to do and you don't do it. In the book of James, the scripture says that you sin in doing that. You see, you have to believe you can be worryless and fretless. In 1 Peter 5:7, it says, casting all your care upon him, for he cares for you. How do we cast our cares upon the Lord, intercessors? You know, I'm talking to intercessors because I know intercessors can carry the burden of the world on themselves. And when you see them, they are sad. They look sad. I really thank God that God helped me. I remember one time I went for a prayer meeting and, the prayer leader, it was in a midnight watch. It was a prayer night. So in the night season, we said, please get hold of somebody's hand and you begin to pray. So I remember at that time I was still I had not yet started. I had not ever had a family. I was just a young man. And my demeanor was not I didn't have a big body. I was very small. So I get hold of this intercessor and, you know, I really like to say this with a lot of humor because I think that intercessor had a lot of worry, or she was praying about something very heavy. She was like my mother, actually, the age. So I get hold of this one, and now she's the neighbor who was near me, and we began to pray. Hey, nakwambia nilirushwa yo mkono. Father, chwa, nafanya mkono hivi, nafanya mkono yangu hivi. Hey, nikasikia kweli. Hey, hiyo maombi tunaombea Kenya, Mungu amesikia. Intercessors, please. Do not carry the burden with yourself. You know, like when you are told somewhere, hii ndio headquarter ya wachawi na waganga wote. Hapa ndio wachawi wanakuja. So mtumishi wa Mungu anakuja next week. Intercessors, kujeni muombe kwa sababu ya hiyo mkutano. There are some people, when you look at the face, vile anakaa, amebeba hiyo shida. Hiyo shida mnaombea amebeba hapo kwa uso yake. You should not carry the burden. The burden should be with the Lord. Cast your care upon him, for he cares for you. This day, in the name of Jesus, whatever cares you may be carrying, beloved of God, put those cares to the Lord. And then when you go in to do your work, as you do your work, you don't have the cares. The Lord is taking care of all the tares in your life, all the weeds that have been planted in the night. The Lord is going to uproot them in the name of Jesus. So how do we cast our cares upon the Lord? I don't know how we could do it except through praying the prayer of commitment. The prayer of commitment. The word prayer is not mentioned here, but I don't know any other way to be a doer of 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 7 than to do it through prayer of commitment. The prayer of commitment. We talked about the prayer of commitment in another one where we mentioned it. But now let me just recap it as we continue. What are you doing to do about, what are you going to do about the anxieties and the things you're fretting about, the financial obligations? They are very huge. Huge financial obligations that you may be carrying, you know. The things that, you know, believers may be going through, things that people are going through. God is saying, Lord, he's given you the cares. Cast all your cares upon the Lord. Why not cast them? Cast them where? Cast them upon the Lord, casting all your care upon Him, for He cares for you. Hallelujah. Be careful for nothing. Don't be anxious about anything. In other words, don't fret or have any anxiety about anything. What are you going to do then? Be careful for nothing. But in everything, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, make your request known to God. That this Bible verse say, let your request be known to God in little things. Yes. Even in the little things. What about big things? Yes, even in the big things. In the sort of middle-sized things. In the super big things. Yes, in everything. We are to pray and make our requests known to God. I have heard some people say, well, I wouldn't bother God with little cares and anxieties. I can handle them myself. In fact, there are people who say, I don't need to pray about that. I just need to do it. I just need the money. And then, in fact, you have it. You have it. You think it's the money that does it. But then you realize there's a certain thing that money cannot do. There's a certain level you will ask people how much and they'll tell you, we just have to wait, madam. There's nothing we can do. Haven't you heard people say, but God doesn't want you to fret or be anxious about anything, big or small. The Bible says, but in everything by prayer. You've heard people say that. I don't want to bother people. You've heard people say, I've heard people, mimi personally, nimesikia watu wakisema, sitaki kusumbua Mungu. I would not want to bother God with little cares and anxieties. I can handle myself. Haven't you heard people say that? I'm sure you have. Or maybe even you have said it yourself. But God says, He doesn't want you to fret or be anxious about anything. Even as an intercessor, do not fret, do not worry about anything. Even if that burden is how big, you know. For me, whenever I get a revelation about the nearing of the rapture, it gives me so much joy to know that as many people as are getting saved, they will not miss the great coming of the great King. That our Lord Jesus Christ will step on the mount in Jerusalem. The same way we saw Him go. He will come back in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. And the dead will be raised back up to life. Will you be sensitive to know what God is doing in the nations? Be sensitive, intercessor. Because the Great Commission is not something that shall just remain being in a local setup. The Lord says that He shall make you disciples of nations. This is the thing, that God wants you to be able to bring others to salvation. As you travel the world, as you do your business, as you do the activities you are doing in your day, as your week is unfolding, the God of glory wants you to know what is happening in the nations. You know, what is happening in your nation, in Kenya. You know, the things that are happening in Kenya. When you look at the things happening in Kenya, you will be surprised to know that the church sometimes is very silent about things that it should not be silent about. So we are trusting God on a day like this that we pray for the nation of Israel, that we are casting all our cares upon the Lord. In our prayer of importunity, in our prayer of commitment, we are telling God, my Father, we cast all our cares before You. In the name of Jesus, we cast all our cares. In the name of Jesus, we cast all our cares in You. In the name of Jesus Christ, we thank You, our Father. Thank You, Lord Jesus, for Your help is upon us. Thank You, Lord, for the supernatural. We thank God for the wonderful, wonderful, wonderful work that we are seeing You're doing in the nations of the earth. Thank You, Lord, for the move of God that we have seen in Gaza. Lord, we have seen this thing, Lord, in the nations, Lord. We've seen children die, we've seen old people die. But Lord, we have also seen the hostages that were actually captured and taken into Gaza. Four of them were rescued. Lord, we are thankful that You are doing something, even as we continue to pray and as we continue to look to You, Father. We also pray that many will be saved in Israel. that many will be saved in Israel. We pray for many to be saved in Israel. We pray that, Lord, even that you will help us. Lord, it's my desire to be that Ethiopian official, Lord. The one who was in Jerusalem. I want to be that Ethiopian official and have my chariot right there. And Lord, I just want to pray that, God, you're going to do these things. Yeah, so the word of God is upon us in Jesus' name. Philippians 4 verse 6. Then we have other people who will take their little cares of life to the Lord in prayer. But without saying it, they seem to leave the impression that some cares are too big for him to handle. And they won't cast those big cares upon the Lord. But thank God, he's interested in everything that concerns us, because he is our Father. Casting all your care upon him, for he cares for you. Even a house. It looks like a big care, but yes, the Lord desires that you will live in your own house, that you don't have to struggle about rent. Even churches, that churches don't have to pay rent. Churches need to have their land, that they pay for it, and they'll be able to be blessed and continue to increase, build schools, build hospitals, build police stations. For that the police may bring care and order. Not that may arrest. You know, I it's very amazing that we have communities that have prisons without people inside. Because of the love of Jesus in their communities. So why in the world would we want to go on fretting and worrying? Yet Paul tells us these things. I have seen this motto written. Why pray when you can worry? I know whoever wrote this was trying to be funny. But sometimes think that is actually the motto of some Christians in life. Why pray when you can worry? There are some Christians that they're actually taking the motto, why pray when you can worry? And they choose to worry. But that should not be. The Lord is saying, pray and don't worry. And the Christian's motto should be, why worry when you can pray? Trust in Jesus, he knows the way. Why worry when you can pray? Why worry when you can pray? I can just remember this from Sunday school. I think I used to sing this once. I can't remember where. Why worry when you can pray? I wonder if there's a song. Oh yeah, there's a song actually from someone here. Let me try and see if something. This is from Jamaica. He knows the way. St. Thomas. When you can pray. Worry when you can pray. Trust in Jesus, he knows the way. Don't be like doubting Thomas. When you can pray. Why worry when you can pray? Trust Jesus, he knows the way. Hallelujah. Thomas, Jesus, if you can pray, at least you have gotten the chorus. Why worry when you can pray? Trust Jesus, he leads the way. Don't be like doubting Thomas. Just have faith and trust him in his way. Why worry? Why worry? Why worry? Woo, Jesus, we love you so much for this revelation. Why worry, intercessor, that the world is coming to an end? There's another person who had told us, of course, it was not going to come to pass. Someone said, I am a prophet and I had a night. And in the night, the Lord said, the world is ending in May 30th. So sell your worldly possession. And I just asked myself, why do I need worldly possession? If at all the Lord is coming, why should I need to worry about the worldly things? Because I will not take them with me. They will be left down here for everybody down here to get them. You go to Egypt today and you find the big pyramids there. They are full of treasures, golden treasures. You know, you find things that people buried away, but they cannot carry them with you. So, dear intercessor, intercede more for the eternal things, things that cannot be destroyed by rust and moth. Lead people to Christ. Why worry when you can pray? Trust in Jesus. He lead the way. Philippians 4:6 is what Paul is saying to us in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Good to see you, Anthony. What a joy the Lord is doing in the mighty name of Jesus. Also, did you notice that Paul said, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. Paul really said several things here. First, he said, don't worry. I don't care what the situation or circumstance. Don't worry about it. Don't be full of anxiety about it. Don't be fretting about it. Second, Paul said, in everything, pray and let your requests be known to God. Everything includes everything. Every problem, every situation, every circumstance, every anxiety, every care or concern. Nothing is excluded. Pray about that situation, but don't worry about it. Thirdly, say, pray with thanksgiving. Some people don't pray with thanksgiving. Their prayers are not closed with thanksgiving. They are more likely closed with a moan or a groan or a sigh, which all indicate doubt and unbelief. But Paul said to pray with thanksgiving about the outcome of their prayers. That is praying in faith. Hallelujah! Pray with faith. Thanksgiving is to be offered unto God before your answer has ever materialized. Paul said, we are to pray with thanksgiving. When you pray with thanksgiving, you are thanking God ahead of time because you know that he has heard you and answered you. He's heard you because his word says so. In Mark 11:24, there is something we have missed and have overlooked in receiving answers to prayer. I believe that if people would stop asking God for the same thing over and over and would begin to praise and thank him for the answer, they would receive the answer to their prayers. For example, in our discussion of prayer, praise, and worship, the prayer of praise and worship, I mentioned the story of the young minister who was holding a meeting at a certain church and went with the pastor's wife to pray for a baby who was having convulsions. The young preacher said that he did everything he had seen others do, such as anointing the baby with oil, rebuking the devil, but nothing worked. It was only when they began to praise and thank God from their hearts that the baby was completely healed. The healing came while they were praising and thanking God. We need to be constantly reminded of some of these prayer secrets. The prayer secrets are begin to thank God before you see anything. You remember we talked about Paul and Silas in the book of Acts 16, 25 and 26. Paul and Silas had been in prison. They had been in jail. They were in the inner jail. This incident in jail may be what Paul was referring to in Philippians 4:6. Paul was writing what he had experienced. He said, in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let my request be known to God. Let your request be known to God. Paul wrote this letter to the church at Philippi while he was in the prison. And he's also writing this letter to you, dear intercessor, that fret not. Their backs were bleeding because they had been beaten. The Bible says at midnight, Paul and Silas prayed. That prayer, that scripture doesn't stop there. That would be the story. The scripture should have stopped there for many people. But for Paul and Silas, they sang praises. You see, if it was after they prayed that they sang praises to God, it goes on to say that the prisoners heard them. God heard them. You know the story. Then writing to the church in Philippi, Paul wrote, with thanksgiving, let your request be known to God. Then it says, at the peace of God, and the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, shall keep your hearts
and minds through, you said that the peace of God that surpasses all human understanding shall keep your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus, Philippians 4:7. If you will do what verse 6 says to do, that is pray with thanksgiving, then verse 7 will become a reality in your life. I really don't know of any other way to get this peace except to follow the instructions God has given us in His Word. Then the peace of God, which passes understanding or natural human reasoning, shall keep your heart and mind through Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. The word peace, shalom, the fruit of the Spirit, peace, cometh. You pray until God give you peace and you begin to hear Him. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What a joy to see what God does, you know, whenever we pray and trust Him. Ay, 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 ay. That, you know, today is Mission Monday as I come to you now. And as I received a new set of instructions from the Lord, I will only be able to share with you the report. I cannot tell you where I'm going. I cannot tell you. Oh, my God. I cannot tell you much. I will go and I will stay as the Lord enables me. This is the help we are talking about. Totally at rest, totally no. You know, someone the other day came and told me something about, you know, the missions and everything that I'm doing. That is not in line with the word of God. So I said, Lord, I do not receive instruction by being led by people. They say, you should come also here. You should go and do here. You should... If you see, this is why, dear intercessor, as you pray for the men and women of God, pray for them to hear God. Pray for them to have everything they need. Pray for them that God will give them that capacity to keep on asking God for their needs and all those things. So that in this way, the man of God is well supplied for. And also participate in giving towards missions. Participate. The ones that you can be able to go participate. You must be able to participate in the word of God. Participation, you know, that's why you see people sometimes they withhold what God has given them, and they say, "Ay, apana, I'm not the one to go and stand in front of the church and tell them these things." You know, like when I was sharing with you about, you know, certain things that God has put in me that are not in line with His word in congregational worship in the local church. So it is now up to wisdom, that God give you wisdom to go and use the right channel. Do not just do it like you are not a person of wisdom and understanding. You use the right channel to talk to the right people, and finally you sit down with your pastor or your bishop and tell them, "Bishop, I don't think it is proper for the worship team to come in those wedding gowns to sing for us. Some of those wedding gowns are tight. They hold their bodies. Some of these singers you see standing before the altar and they are shaming the body of Christ. Some of them, when last they were out there, they did not check that their body size is different. So the event is tomorrow, and the dress that they have gotten for a lot of euros and dollars is here. Then they wear and the dress is so tight. So instead of discarding it, they say, hii ndio ile dress nilisema ni ya kuimbisha kwa ile album launch yangu. The person comes in front of the altar and, oh my God, even the angels are not able to minister, because right then, demons of lust are flowing from this person. Do you know what demons do? They just need a legal ground. The woman might be even standing in front of the church singing and praising in tongues, but their body is representing lustful desires and all these things. So demons will come and invade the congregation. Lustful thoughts, lustful desires. Others will start looking at other pictures that are not appropriate. Why? Because one person in that church congregation made a door open for lust in the church. So these are the things, as an intercessor, when you see them, you don't move from that church. No, you don't move. That is why God wants you there. begin to pray first. Begin to pray. But there are those ones that are doing that intentionally. So if you discover you're in such kind of a church, dear intercessor, you gotta leave that place. The Lord is instructing you now to make the right decision and leave the place where the brethren are encouraging sexual desires to go on. You want them to continue. Even there are some things that are shameful we cannot talk about here. So remember what Paul says about prayer. The peace that surpasses all human understanding. It's lacking in some of our congregations all across the world. There's no peace in the church. Why? Because the church is not praying. It says the peace of God that transcends all human understanding will come upon the church. The psalmist said, "Forever, O Lord, thy word is exalted." You know. So I refuse to worry and be fretful about this. I bring this to you. This is what Peter also says. The care and anxiety. 1 Peter 5:7. Casting your whole cares, all your anxieties. You would think that preachers know this verse in the Bible, wouldn't you? But you'd be surprised that they say, even others switch on to say, Peter was saying to the early church. And you know, now huyo mtu anajitoa. Usijitoe kwa neno la Mungu. Stay in the word of God. Remain in the pages. Even if it's in the Old Testament, it's fulfilled in Christ. So it must be fulfilled in Christ. Do not try and run, you know, go round the word of God. Go round. Unataka kutafuta kanjia tu. Useme hapana, hiyo sio yangu. Mungu alisema tukule kila kitu, tuvae vile tunataka. That is not in the word of God. So mind needs to grow quiet because I give place to the word instead of to worry. I want to mention this one very clearly, that you need to understand this, that you have to go back to a time or two in prayer and repeat the prayer whereby you say, Lord, for my own benefit, my mind will begin to grow quiet because I give place to the word instead of to worry. When I give place to the word, my spirit begins to dominate me. You know, this peace will come if you walk in genuine faith, doing what the Bible says to do. Because God said, this peace will garrison both your mind and your spirit. If you go on Langata Road, if you are in Nairobi, Kenya, and you go and see the Langata Barracks, how the military, how they guard that place. There's once, you know, I had to go through, I had to go in one of those places where you have military. And I'm telling you, the guards, even at the gates, they find out how are you, you are, what's your ID, you give them your ID. Then they tell you, we don't trust your car, please leave it there. Then you walk in, again others search you, and then you walk again. So much protocol. Why? Because that's a garrison. That is a place of guarding the nation. Both your mind and your spirit. And you will never see the military of any country walking around buying ice cream in the town. You'll not find them. I mean, you just think in your head, when is the last time you saw a soldier walking around? Very rare. Unless you are in the places where they are under operation. There have been times when I have cast all my cares upon the Lord. And after falling off to sleep, for some reason or another, I awakened. And the moment I was awakened, the devil brought to my mind again the critical situation I was facing at that time. Do you know what I did when that happened? This is part of receiving the peace beyond all understanding. I just started laughing. right? Okay, I don't want to laugh now. But I just kept starting to laugh. Right in the night time, you know, just burst out laughing. That is beyond our understanding or natural human reasoning. But the Lord always took care of the situation. How in the world could a person be laughing in the midst of trouble? Yet when you have this peace, you can laugh right in the face of trouble, even death. After I was healed and raised off from that sick bed that I was in. If you see that small video, I was dancing, I was singing to God and praising God. I was laughing, and the doctors were looking at me. What's wrong with this man? This man is not going to fall. In fact, the nurse, you know, before I was healed, the nurses were carrying me. They were trying to tell me to. The moment that they were now removing me from the mask, for some reason, that ventilation mask, for some reason, I was still like, oh no. Some part of me was trying to say, oh, I've gotten used to the mask. Why now remove it? But then I just let the doctor do his job, because God had healed my sickness. Hallelujah. I am going to live. I'm not going to die. If you try to tell most people they can love in the midst of trouble because they have the peace of God that's within you, they cannot understand. If you have to be to the place where you stood your ground, where you stay, standing on your ground right there. Stand your ground on the word of God. Stay in the arena of faith. Stay in the arena of faith. Stand your ground. When your faith was severely tried and challenged, you can understand it. But if you haven't, it would probably be hard for you to understand it. Paul also tells us this thing. Think on the right things. We talked about Philippians 4, 6 and 7. God tells us in these verses how to pray with thanksgiving, which includes having the joy of the Lord. Pray until your joy is full, and how to have the peace that passes understanding when you pray. Even when you want to change your product, the product that you are selling, if at all you see that, all of a sudden I have no interest in this product, I want to change into another product, pray about it and then begin to thank God for the new product. Even though you've not seen it, thank God for the new product. Say, Lord, thank you that you're giving me a new product. I'm a consultant by excellence. I am the head and not the tail. I move into new dimensions. I move. Hallelujah. I do. Hey, sujiseme, mbele za Bwana. Yes, declare, pray. And then after that, thank God. Hallelujah. Obtain mercy. Find grace. Thank God. You are experiencing the supernatural in the name of Jesus Christ. Think the right things. After we pray and cast our cares upon the Lord, this peace of God guards our hearts and minds. There is still something else we must do. If we aren't careful, our minds will still try to slip back into thinking negative thoughts. The devil, through our minds, will endeavor to defeat us. Listen, church, do you know how the devil gets in? Through your eyes. Oh, what are you watching? What are you listening to? That is where he is coming to your mind. He's showing you, look at how the economy is broken down. Look, that place they're shutting down. That place they're shutting down. Oh, no, look at that one. Oh, wale walienda nyumbani, wale. So in your mind, the devil is pumping that picture back to you. But if you come, fill your mind with the word of God. Hallelujah. The devil, through our minds, will endeavor to defeat us. But thanks be to God that I cast all my cares, all my burdens, all my fears. I cast all my anxieties upon the Lord. And I pray about every single matter. And the peace of God that surpasses human understanding is guarding my heart and mind right now in the name of Jesus upon the nation of Kenya. We are standing in the promises of God over the nation. Ha ha. Woo! Philippians 4:8, it says, finally, brethren, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are honest, whatsoever things are just, whatsoever things are true, whatsoever things are lovely, whatsoever things are of good report, if there be any virtue or if any praise, think on these things. I call it the holy checklist. What are you about to talk about? Is it on the checklist? Is it true? Is it praiseworthy? Is it of a good report? If it is not in the holy checklist, destroy it. Uproot it from your life. Many times people will say about a negative thought, yes, but it's true. Well, all things are true, but which are not pure and lovely. You see, once you get to this place where you have this peace that passes all understanding, if you want to keep it, you are going to have to think on the right things. If you want to keep the peace, dear intercessor, like I mentioned to you, there is so much that the enemy is sleeping under the mat, under the table, is trying to get it through the window, and is trying to get in by all means necessary. You know, I'm a wildlife lover and I take photographs of wildlife in my free time. And I was watching a documentary about some dragons. Actually, they are dragons in, I don't know which, it's one of these, Amazon or something. So there's this one dragon that wanted to kill a buffalo. So the dragon is so big for the buffalo. No, the buffalo is so big for the dragon. So what the dragon had to do was just go and bite a little part of the leg of the buffalo. Iliuma tu yo buffalo kidogo hivi kwa mgu. Huh? Ikauma kidogo. Ikauma tu. So the buffalo inafanya tu pembe hivi, that dragon inawachwa hapo. But do you know what started to happen with that dragon? It started to follow that buffalo. And the documentary maker stayed with that same buffalo for about 3 weeks. And this dragon would just be escorting. It would just be escorting the he would be escorting the buffalo. And the times, sometimes when he comes close, he would bite again. So they, unknown to anybody, the dragon's teeth had poison. It has poison. But it takes a long time to take effect. But eventually, one day, the buffalo died in the night. And Mr. Dragon, with all the other dragons, they came. They look, these are huge, very ugly looking lizards. They came and they ate on the buffalo. And I looked at that and I learned something, that the enemy sometimes is not looking to get you to, is not going looking to hit you at once. Anaanza pole pole. Anakupeleka kwa duka tu. Anakuonyesha kitu. Just something. He brings you something. He wants to bring your mind to think on what is wrong. But what is the Bible saying about this thing? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We thank God. It says, in Isaiah chapter 26 verse 3, thou wilt keep him in perfect peace, whose mind is steadfast, whose mind is stayed on thee, because he trusts you. Isaiah 26 verse 3. Many people need to change their way of thinking in order to be successful in their Christian walk. Yet it scares some people if you teach about the mind. I have thought along these lines in some of our churches. And I have even heard the pastor say that something like this will take a little, that like it's something like Christian science. But it is not Christian science what we are talking about. It is Christian sense. I have noticed that when people are talking about the negative side of everything, you will have a dark outlook on life. You will see something bad in everything around you. So sometimes we miss it in the world by looking at worldly conditions. Like I was sharing you, some of the songs which are out there today, they are not songs that are praising God. They are songs that are bringing glory to the singers. That now we are looking at the success of our gospel song based on the views. If at all it has more views on the YouTube, then we are quick to accept it as a form of a hymn. And the real hymns, the ones that talk the word of God, you'll go there, you'll find they don't have many people watching them because they consider those are old songs. But I want to tell you something. Sometimes we will miss it when we start focusing on the world conditions. Things look bad. It's true. The situations and circumstances we face in life are real. We all face real trials and life and experience the unpleasant conditions of this world. All these things are true. All are right. But they are not necessarily just. They are not pure or lovely. Yet some people let some of these things worry them to death. So to speak, the Bible says, if there be any virtue, or if there be any praise,
Think about these things. You see, right in the midst of trouble, instead of being overcome, thank God we should overcome. Instead of being overcome, overcome, dear intercessor. Be a victor instead of being downcast. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Be happy instead of being discouraged. Hey, glory to God. Be joyful. Hallelujah. Be encouraged. Hallelujah. Can you see what I'm talking about? You can pray for people and help them temporarily. You can bring them into contact with God and His power. But as long as they don't change their thinking, they will get right back where they were and be defeated. I've seen a number of people who were helped in some of the circumstances they were in. Yet in the process of time, they go back into the same problems where they were before, because of their habit of thinking is wrong, is thinking wrong thoughts. Even when you talk about healing, when you stay in the place of healing, you must remain declaring the word of God, thinking about those things. Hallelujah. Think about those things. Crush the head of Satan. That's the word of God in Romans 16:20. Jesus did it already. Hallelujah. I shared with you the other night about how I was praying from Psalm 68. Oh, let God arise and let all your enemies be scattered. And the Lord said to me, I did it. Oh, glory to God. He already scattered his enemies. I gotta stand on the word of God and believe that he has scattered all the enemies. And I am walking in victory because he has given me great, great power and authority in the name of Jesus Christ. That it's not sparingly I will use the name. I'll use the name for small things. I will use the name for middle-sized things. I will use the name for big things. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I pray to the Father. Woo! Woo! Glory! I am not a whiner. I will not whine. I will not whine. Hey, glory to Jesus. You see these things, beloved? The word, the confession of your mouth. Don't get back to whining and complaining through life. That negativity would allow the enemy to take advantage of you and bring you back to the same condition or the same kind of sickness or disease. Beloved, we are grateful that we have looked at different principles of prayer found in what Jesus taught. We shared about the principle of prayer found in Paul's epistles to the churches. And we have seen how important praying in tongues is. When you're praying for things which you don't know how to pray for. We also discussed something about how we refuse to worry about anything. We are to allow the peace of God to rule in our hearts and minds. As we study these different scriptures, we are learning the word of God says, beloved of the Lord. As we come to a close of this session right now, I just want to thank God for giving us capacity. Beloved, let me just mention that the ways of God are not like our ways. Because, as you remember, how we began doing these prayer watches is just by a divine instruction. Divine instruction from the Lord. He said, you're doing the journey of 150 days of Psalms. Beautiful, that's a good one. But I want you to train intercessors on prayer without ceasing. Pray without ceasing. And also to key into the gates of time. So, this is not what the scripture is. Okay, basically, this is a way that the Lord has helped us that today, now, we are able to pray longer than before and with understanding. So, you still have some more 2 hours for you to finish. If at all you are keying in the whole watch, just as we are closing, the prayer, biblical prayer watches begin at 6 p.m. all the way to 9 p.m. That is considered the first watch. The second prayer watch comes in at 9 p.m. to midnight. That's called the second watch in the Bible. Then the third watch or the middle watch is the prayer of 12 a.m. to 3 a.m. 3 hours. Then we have again the fourth watch, which is the one that is a very crucial time.
when we are entering the dawn, the darkest dawn, it's at 3 a.m. to 6 a.m. And then we have, that's actually a good time for miracles and manifestations and great things happening there. And then we have the fifth watch of the Bible is comes in at 6 a.m. all the way to 9 a.m. And then we have the sixth watch, which is the one we were on, at 9 a.m. to 12 p.m., 3 hours of time. Then we have the seventh watch, or what we call the prayer hour, in the mighty name of Jesus, coming in at midday. Not the prayer hour, we call it here the victory hour, midday. Midday. Up on your check is in a clear. Yo, masa. That's midday, 12 to 3 a.m. to 3 p.m. is the third, is the seventh watch. And then the last watch is the eighth watch. Eighth watch is what is referred to in the Bible as the prayer hour. What you read in the book of Acts is the prayer hour is in at 3 p.m. is that one. So no matter where you are in the world, you will have a 3 p.m. somewhere. You will have a 6 p.m. somewhere. So you are no longer now looking at, I must pray with the Kenyan time or American time. Just you follow as the Lord leads you and be able to be at least consistent with prayer, and you will see what God will do. Amen. I believe that one you have received understanding. If not, we are still going to come back and train ourselves on this. Let me pray as we close it in the mighty name of Jesus. Thank you, my Father, for this wonderful moment that you have granted unto us to be in your presence. Thank you, Lord, for the teaching about what Paul said. Thank you, Lord, for this divine revelation, Lord. Thank you for also helping us to pray with thanksgiving. Thank you for training us as intercessors. Thank you, Lord, for helping us to eat and to chew on the right meat, oh God. So, Father, we stand in the place of authority and declare all things done in the name of Jesus. It's done in the name of Jesus with thanksgiving. We also pray for the Mission Monday, oh God. With thanksgiving, oh God. With thanksgiving. With thanksgiving, oh God. We give you thanks, our Father. With thanksgiving. With thanksgiving, oh Lord. We give you thanks, our Father. Oh Lord. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you for provision. Thank you that the chariot has all the fuel it needs. It has all the maintenance it needs. Thank you, Lord, for all the other needs are met. Father, we thank you. We continue to stand in the place of prayer. We continue to stand in the place of prayer in victory and dominion. And we know that you are faithful. We know that you are true. We know that you are just. You will help us to adjust. For you are Yeshua and you are ever sure. And we stand knowing that you are helping us. You are a great God who answers prayer. Thank you, Heavenly Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray with thanksgiving. And all the intercessors say, Amen. Hallelujah. Let us share in the words of the grace together as we end this sixth watch. Hallelujah. Now, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Amen. Shalom. Shalom.